What's up, everybody? It's your boy Red X Black, and I'm back with another video. We got another election. Well, it's not really a prediction today, but it's a hypothetical based on current polling data and current polling trends. I'm gonna show what the election map would look like based on polling from current battleground states. So let me show you the current polling, and then we're gonna come back. So as you can see right here, these are the current polling results from Siena from June 8th to June 18th, based on New York Times Siena College poll of 3,870 people. I didn't see the polling margin of error. I'm not sure. I'm going to guess that it's maybe in the 2-3% range. I'm not sure. But these are the current battleground state polls. That it's part of the long trend of Biden being like up very significantly over Trump, especially after what's been going on for the past month. Trump has taken a major dive. So this is Michigan. Michigan is plus 11, Wisconsin plus 11, Pennsylvania is plus 10, Florida plus 6, Arizona plus 7, North Carolina plus 9. Now I'm gonna show you with the map. We're gonna go ahead and get back to the map. I'm gonna show you what it would look like if these were the results currently. So let's get back to that. All right, so before we get back to the map, I just want to also show the breakdown of the demographic breakdown among all. This is if the election was held today. This is still the Siena New York Times poll. If the election was held today, whom would you vote for? All registered voters, Biden plus 14, female plus 22, male plus 3, 18 to 34, Biden plus 34, 35 to 49, Biden plus 23, 50 to 60, plus Trump plus 1, 65 and older, Biden plus 2. Now, you see how close it gets between with the older folks. There's going to be a little bit of a war between the older population, because it's like that 50 to 60 range, that's Trump, 65 older, that's Biden. And you know, it just depends on what they like in the candidate the most, who's more respectable or whatnot. You know, some of them watch a lot of Fox News and a lot of CNN and MSNBC. Sorry, that's a generalization, my bad. Black plus 74, Hispanic plus 39. Biden was actually struggling with the Hispanic vote for a little minute now. They only asked 150 and 145 people. Okay. But white college educated, there is Biden plus 28, white, Trump plus 1. Jesus. White non-college, Trump plus 19. So usually, you know, the black vote is pretty much on lock for Biden. And even after all his quote unquote gaffes, they're not really gaffes, it's just how he feels with the whole, hey, you ain't black if you don't vote for me, you know what happened. So that's still on lock for him. Hispanics, now they move a little differently. They first, the Hispanic vote was like, it was like neck and neck, and Trump was even almost leading with the Hispanic vote at one point, like a few months ago. But after all the George Floyd incident happened, then you had the protests, the riots, and now it's like everything is just changing rapidly now. So that the dynamics have really flipped. Even if people aren't necessarily excited for Biden, but it's like almost just a rejection of Trump. So white voters, Trump is still plus one. He still holds a 1-point lead with them. They should have really asked more people. But white non-college, Trump is going to still hold on to them because a lot of them are more working class. And Biden, with his track record, he has really hurt a lot of the working class voters. And Trump, I don't know if he could say he's done, you know, better, because he talks about outsourcing and stuff like that. So Trump still outsourced a lot of jobs. I think he outsourced, don't quote me on this, but I think he outsourced more jobs in his first year or two than Obama did pretty much in like 7 to 8 years. So that you can keep talking your populist rhetoric, but it doesn't really change what you're going to do, apparently. Democrat, Biden plus 85. Independent, Biden plus 21. It's surprising that Biden's leading with independents, because usually independents will favor the more, or what they assume to be the anti-establishment candidate. They do not like establishment candidates, because I'm an independent. I hate establishment. But Trump, he has a lot of populist rhetoric, but when it comes down to a lot of the policies, it's not much different from other presidents. Republican, Trump plus 85, and so yeah, that's regular. So Biden and Trump both have their party base on lock, but the real meat and bones is the independent. The independent vote is what's most important, and will sway an election as well. Now, ideology, very liberal, Biden plus 83, somewhat liberal, Biden plus 69, moderate. You know, that's actually surprising. That's really surprising that the moderates are only plus 33. Remember, they're always screaming about moderates, and Biden, you have to appeal to the moderates and this and then you have to be moderate, you have to be in the center. Now, he's only plus 33 with his dear moderate voters. How does that make any sense? But somewhat conservative, Trump plus 32, very conservative, Trump plus 73. That just blows my mind a little bit that moderates, he's only plus 33 with them. That was the people he was catering to. It was the quote unquote moderate. It's crazy that the very liberal and somewhat liberal people are plus 83. I guess you could say this is because of the size of the people that they asked, but still, that just blows my mind a little bit. But anyway, let's get back to the map. So, as you just saw right there, Biden is up significantly in these battleground states. Now, will this be the final result? I have no idea. I don't think so. I mean, it's unlikely for him to really do that, like, to cause that big of a flip from 2016. But with 2020, anything's possible now. So I wouldn't be shocked. But I think this election is honestly going to be close when it comes down to it. So if those results were the current results, you had Florida plus 6, that goes to him. I can't really with what I'm using right now, I can't really show the percentage or lean likely. It doesn't do that on this map. Maine's split, I'm assuming if this is some type of landslide election, Maine at large is going to go to Biden. Nebraska, that's going to stay with Trump. And you had Michigan plus 11, I believe, and Wisconsin plus 11, Pennsylvania, I think it was, what was it, plus 10, maybe? That's New Jersey. So New Mexico will be blue. Oh, Colorado will be blue. And you would have Arizona, and it would be blue as well. North Carolina was plus 9, I believe. I cannot remember. I just looked at the poll. But so that is 321 electoral votes. That is a landslide. That is a straight up landslide. Would this happen? Virginia. Excuse me, guys. So 334 electoral votes. Would this happen? I doubt this would happen, because polls, they are almost like a snapshot, and there's not that level of there's an energy out there right now, but I don't think it's to this magnitude where people see Biden as like some like savior, or they have this passion and energy behind them. Some people may, others are just like, hey, we're just gonna vote for him to get the other dude out. So there's not this crazy like energy behind him right now. So if this did happen, I would think that this result right here would be almost like a reaction and basically an overthrowing to the current state of affairs. And it's not like, oh, we love Biden, this, that, and the other. Some people do. Trust me, it's what people do. But this result would almost be just like a reaction to just how things have been handled for the past few months. And just kind of like a referendum, basically. That's what I would think that this reaction would be. Now, I'm going to go to, let's see, is this the 2016 map? Yeah, that's the 2016. This is the 2016 result. So, if this is, I'm going to go ahead and give another prediction right now, currently off of, based off of what I think the map will look like. Because I guess you could say this is my second prediction. So I think that Michigan may end up, I got to go back to, where's my map? What are you doing? Sorry, guys. I'm still trying to figure out how to work this thing. Okay. I don't want to look at the 2016 map anymore. I definitely don't want to go to 1876. Let me just hit back. Nope. I hate ads. But okay, so Michigan, I think it's going to go blue. New Mexico is obviously going to be blue, most likely. And Florida, I think Florida may stay in Trump's column. I don't think North Carolina is flipping right now, unless there is like this energy stays up and the population, the black population in North Carolina continues like it's... If they come out and show up in massive numbers, then North Carolina may flip. But that would only be if this energy continues. Wisconsin. I don't know. Like, I honestly don't know if Wisconsin will flip or not, because Wisconsin has been trending more red recently. So I'm going to leave Wisconsin in... I would put it in, if I had the option, I would put it in the tilt Trump column right now, but if it goes red, then that wouldn't be a very shocking, you know, surprise. Arizona. Now, I actually think that Arizona may flip blue. Now, I know people may, like, you know, kind of flame me for that a little bit, or how could you say that would flip blue? Hear me out. The type of candidate that Biden is, the way Arizona's electorate votes and the type of candidates that they like, the centrist, corporate type candidates like Biden. Like Meghan McCain, her dad was from that state, John McCain, and she's more the corporate type, centrist type person. And that's kind of like a reflection of Arizona. I'm not, cause anybody from Arizona, I'm not saying you all are Meghan McCain, but that seems to be the type of candidate that they would like. So Arizona with the, cause Trump is underwater, what do you call it? With his approval ratings in Arizona. So, you know, I think it can narrowly go to Biden, maybe by 2 points, or even if that, maybe 1 point, or 1.5 points. So I think that's what that could look like, because this energy is pretty massive right now, and I don't think that it is going to go like that. And Pennsylvania. Now, Pennsylvania... If it goes red, Trump wins. If it goes blue, Biden wins. So this election, to me, it could come down to either Pennsylvania, Wisconsin, or maybe even Arizona. Because I don't think Florida's going to flip if Florida's results come in the same night. But as of right now, I think Pennsylvania could go to Biden, because that's a big... Pennsylvania is a state that... They are very, what do I want to say? They have some of the oil and gas industry. A lot of states have oil and gas industry. So does mine. Mine's Louisiana. But with Biden's plan, his new energy plan, his green energy plan, the way he goes about it, he's like the just make them learn how to code type person. So what Bernie would have done, Bernie would have helped them be placed in jobs in green energy similar to their current job. And I think that's a better approach than telling somebody to go code or look, we're taking away your job, but you know, you can go find something else to do, right? So if Biden's messaging and campaigning is on point, and maybe if he gets Pittsburgh and Philadelphia, then I think it'll go blue. But or if Philadelphia and Pittsburgh are enough to like overtake the rest of the state, basically, then I think he'll be all right and he may win Pennsylvania. But other than that, this election, it can go either way. So this is my current prediction right here. Trump 258, Biden 280. I don't think anybody's gonna landslide this, because it would take a lot for somebody to landslide this at this point. So yeah, this is my current prediction. Please don't flame me for putting Arizona in Biden's column, because if it goes to him, it might just be by like a point, or if that, or 0.5, like something like Michigan and Wisconsin were back in 2016, like point something. So that's yeah, that's my map. So be sure to like, comment, subscribe, like, comment, subscribe, like, whenever you do it, however you do it, wherever you do it, just do it. It's your boy Red X Black. I'll be back. Peace out.